So now we have it confirmed. Britain in 2022 is a banana republic without the bananas. How else to explain a Truss regime that has proven after just 6 weeks to be the acme of incompetence, ineptitude, stupidity and insanity, to the point where she has blown the actual roof off the UK economy, if you want to imagine the economy as a house that needs a floor and a roof in order to remain weatherproof. And the resulting deluge that has come down into this house, that is the UK economy, has seen the pound fall into its lowest value against the dollar in decades, that has seen pension funds almost running out of money, banks desperately having to buy government bonds to shore up sterling, seen the concomitant pressure on mortgage holders across the country with the spike in interest rates, and seen inflation rise to the point where prices have never been higher relative to incomes in the UK. Kwasi Kwarteng has been made Truss's sacrificial lamb, no doubt under huge pressure from within the Tory party and certainly within the Tory press, but she has to go. He was her appointee. Hitherto, they were the closest of political allies. She bought into his madcap economic strategy. She is a right-wing libertarian crank, and she has to go. There needs to be a general election. She has succeeded in just 6 weeks in losing the Tories, their red wall working class base that they acquired under the premiership of Boris Johnson, with this false rhetoric about levelling up and getting Brexit done. Brexit's not yet been done. We've yet to encounter the full ramifications of this nutty English nationalist nativist project known as Brexit. So the question is, what does the Red Wall do next, given that they are in swing marginal constituencies that have a huge say on who forms a government, which party? I don't think that these people will be minded to vote for Mr. Remain, Sir Keir Starmer. I think they would rather stay at home and not vote for anyone other than a party led by a man who's so wooden that he doesn't put his suit on in the morning, his suit puts him on. I think he's unrelatable to working people. I think he comes over as an alien from a different parallel universe. I think his main role upon becoming elected Labour leader, pledging to be the continuity candidate vis-a-vis Jeremy Corbyn, i.e. to push forward Corbynism without Corbyn, has been to destroy Corbynism on behalf of an establishment whose crimes would shame all the devils in hell. And by God, as he approached that role with gusto, he has banished the left from the Labour Party. The ghost of Corbyn still haunts this rancid establishment. Corbyn came within 2,000 votes of being elected Prime Minister in 2017, despite the treacherous PLP do not look could to in its power to undermine him and undermine his leadership. So this is where we are now. The worst of all possible worlds presented to us is the best of all possible worlds, and it's time for transformative change. I don't think that transformative change can come in the context of the UK in its current format. I think it will have to come with the breakup of the UK. It's time for Scotland to move forward as a modern democratic republic. And it's time for the Irish people to have a say in their future, whether to continue to be part of this sinking ship of fools or to join with the rest of Ireland as part of a modern democratic republic. Just another day in UK politics, but even having the unbelievable reports that there are moves afoot within the Tory party to bring Boris Johnson back as leader of the Tories and as a Prime Minister. And that would certainly put Britain further into the category of banana republic, should that come to pass. This is a kind of chaos out of which fascism is born. Make no mistake about it, this economic chaos and calls for a strong man or strong woman to lead us out of this morass. We have now had 4 Tory prime ministers in 7 years, and 3 of those have come to office without bothering with the inconvenience of a general election and with a mandate from the people of the UK. Scotland can do better. Scotland must do better. England can do better. England must do better. Every constituent part of the UK can and must do better than this utter, utter debacle that they have the temerity to call a democratic system. Peace out.